at that. Almost see twinning in there. Guess what we just found? I think we found what we came for.
Apollo 15, carrying the first lunar rover, lifted off from Cape Kennedy on July 26, 1971. Dave Scott was commander. James Irwin piloted the Lunar Module Falcon. Alfred Warden was the Command Module Endeavour pilot. Once on the lunar surface, the astronauts loaded their geological equipment aboard the rover and drove off. Even at just 7 to 8 miles per hour, Scott likened the drive to a cross between a bucking bronco and a small boat in a heavy swell.
This is really a rock and roll ride, isn't it? Never been on a ride like this before. Oh, boy.
The astronauts made 3 rover trips to collect rocks. Scott said he was continually reminded of the staggering fact that each rock we stored away had been untouched by atmospheric erosion. On the second trip, Scott described mysterious green matter, which geologists determined was part of an original ocean of olivine. In Spur Crater, an excited Scott spotted what had been dubbed the Genesis Rock. Bright crystals sparkling in the sun caught his attention.
Look at that. Almost see twinning in there. Guess what we just found? I think we found what we came for. Crystal rock, huh? Yes, sir. Better believe it.
Geologists estimated this rock at 4.5 billion years old. The crew tallied 8 hours and 37 minutes on the moon, driving the first car there for 17 and a half miles to collect 170 pounds of lunar material. Scott would later write that as he and Irwin rocked and rolled our way back to base camp with the majestic mountains ahead of us, Jim revealed, for the first and only time on the lunar surface, his deeply held religious belief. Dave, Irwin said, I'm reminded of a favorite biblical passage from Psalms. I look unto the hills from whence cometh my help. He added, of course, we get quite a bit of help from Houston, too.